What a joy it is to be with you once more, where we have come by to feast on the Word of God. As I think about the presentation for today, there was many questions, many thoughts that came to mind. But as we face a tropical storm, which is now a hurricane, and the nature of my job, where as soon as the power is out, there is a phone call. There are many phone calls from individuals saying, hey, are you aware that, I don't have any power in this location or that location? And even though the wind is raging outside and it's raining very hard, individuals expect that somebody should ensure that they have adequate supply of electricity, because they might not have a generator to keep them powered up until the problem is past. And as I think about, my coworkers who put their life on the line to the extent to ensure that you are powered, the question came to mind, how so would it be if each and every one of us would cheat God like electricity? Let us pray. Most High Loving Father, as we are about to go into your word, O God, I pray that you empty me of self. Father, let the word, O God, that you have put together this morning be unlike any other. Father, let this word, O God, pierce the heart of somebody. Let this word, O God, move through even me, O God, so that as you word go forth, that somebody may want to get to know you as Lord, Savior, and soon coming King. Father, be with us now as we go into your word, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen. How much so if we treat God like electricity? Now, one of the things that I've learned is that without electricity, a whole country, a whole territory come to an abrupt stop. It is so needed for your economy, for your way of life. Everything that we do in our life need electricity. So my friends, I ask you to visit for me for a short moment, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. My friends, we are going through a period right now where somebody's voltage will be tested. And when I say voltage in electrical term, I'm talking about your faith will be tested. Somebody right now is having low voltage or low faith. Somebody right now is having a phase out, as we use in electrical term or in your term. Somebody right now is having a phase out of their spiritual life. Somebody right now is thinking about giving up because they have been through so much in their life. They don't see the need to go on, because the more that they do is the more attack they're receiving. But I ask you this question. Have you taken the time to look at John 3:16? My friends, we're going through a period where we need to recognize that in advance, God knew that you and I would mess up. But nevertheless, he sent his Son to be the ultimate sacrifice for you and I. In advance, we pierce God daily with our sinful ways. But nevertheless, he still extended grace to each and every one of us. Somebody this morning need to recognize that even though they might be have been disconnected by electricity, even though you might have been disconnected by God, right now you can get reconnected if you just fall on your knees and cry to him. But who is that individual? Or is it you? Who am I speaking to this morning? Somebody needs to recognize right now that God is saying to you, you have been through a rough time, my brother. You have been through a rough time, my sister. But I'm sent by this morning to remind you that you can endure to the end. Somebody need to recognize that the things you're going through, the testimony that you're building right now will be greater than ever before. So while you sit there thinking about disconnecting from the true source of power, Christ Jesus, I ask you this question: why shouldn't you be tested? My friends, we're going through a period when you and I need to recognize when God is working on our behalf. We are going through a period right now, my friends, when you and I need to recognize that God is singling you out. He is singling you out for mission. He is singling you out because he knows that you can endure. Excuse me. But the question is, my friends, what will it take? John 3:16 was the ultimate sacrifice. He gave his only begotten son. He gave his only child, his only seed. He gave his only seed so that you and I can have eternal life. But some of us don't want to give nothing at all, you know. We don't want to let go of the bad habits. We don't want to let go of the things that make us feel so precious. We don't want to let go of that attitude that we need to be disconnected from. There is so much thing that we need to be disconnected from so that God can have his way. But right now, we're still holding on. My friends, we're going through a period when individuals are asking themselves, why should I stay in the church? Why should I trust this God? Because it seems like the more I trust God, the greater the battle. But my friends, the greater the battle is also the greater the victory. So why should you not trust God? We're going through a time right now when we need to recognize that the greater is he that is in me, that is in you, that is in all this earth. And if you don't recognize by now that this world that we are living in will never, ever, ever, ever be the same. The only thing that will be the same is the love that God have for you and I. The only thing that will be the same is the power that God is promising to give you and I once we endure to the end. So we sit back and we cry. And my friends, weeping may endure for a night, but there is a joy that cometh in the morning. Somebody right now need to recognize that you might be in that low situation. You might be in the lowest of lowest moment, but you have stopped by to this channel. You have stopped by to this YouTube channel, this Facebook page, this radio channel, and tune in, or whatever means by which you're hearing my voice. You have stopped by not by chance, but because God have ordained that you be reminded that he is greater than all that you're going through. So the question is, now that you have found the love of Christ, what are you going to do? You see, each and every one of us is saying, you know, I've found Jesus. I've found such a friend. You know, he loved me and I know it. He loved me and I know it. I know Sister Burns loved me. But what do I do to show Sister Burns that I love her as well? I know that God loved me, but what do I do to show God that I love him as well? You see, the thing that I don't understand is that, you know, we talk about love, you know, everybody wants to be loved. Everybody wants to be loved, but who is showing love? We
we're going through a time, my friends, when we need to recognize that John 3:16 is not just a scripture, but it is a sign that the love that God have endured forever and ever, even in the bad times, even in the good times, God still loves you.
Somebody need to recognize this morning that God loves them. Just like the electricity that you need in your home so that we can be in this medium, Jesus Christ need to be even greater in me. My friends, we're going through a period when we need to recognize that if there's ever a time we need God, if there's ever a time that we need the love of God, it's now, because, you know, there is something big about to happen. There is something great about to happen, and only God and God alone can help us. Oh, we just narrowly being spared as Fiona passes by. But God was with us. Some people complain about the electricity go. While in other countries, some people have been flooded. Some people's homes have been completely destroyed. But we don't look at the blessing that God have poured on us. You know, this is how we look. We don't look at how God have been good to us. We complain about the small things, but somebody's having it worse than you. We complain about the small things, but somebody's having it way worse than you. But what if God give you what somebody else is going through? As I go through my challenges in life, in the past, before I understand the love of God, I used to say, God, why me? But right now I'm saying, God, thank you, it is me. Because every time I overcome a challenge in my life, the greater my love for God gets. Every time I overcome a situation in my life, the greater my love for God gets. Every time I overcome that problem in my life, the greater. My relationship gets with God. So my friends, there is somebody right now that need to recognize that God loved them. There is somebody right now that is going through their storm that need to recognize that, just like electricity, you need to recognize that God is in high demand. You need to cry to him, call to him, shout to him, because he's always there. So the question I ask, what will it take for you to recognize that the God that we serve is speaking to you even now? Because just as your life moves, how so the Holy Spirit can move in you. If you're one of those person right now that's saying, God, I want you to move in me. I want you to move in me in a way that you have never moved before. Just raise your hand virtually or physically as you posture yourself for prayer. Most High loving Father, indeed, O God, we are so grateful for your Holy Spirit. Father, we are so grateful for John 3:16, O God, that, you know, while we were still sinners, you sent your Son by to die for each and every one of us. Father, there is somebody right now that is saying, Holy Spirit, I need you to flow with me. There is somebody right now that is looking at their present situation and saying, Holy Spirit, I need you. There is somebody right now that is right down on their knees saying, God, here I am. I need you in my life even now. Father, I pray that as they cry out for you, that your Holy Spirit will move in and through them like never before. I pray, oh God, that you'll continue to bless each family that is represented here this morning. You'll continue to bless the medium by which we are using. You'll continue to broaden our territory so we can tell individuals, oh God, how good of a God that you are and how great is your mercy. And we pray, oh God, that as we are here in one accord this morning, that truly we will recognize that your love is everlasting. And truly we will recognize that there is no power greater than you. Truly we will recognize that electricity is good, but your love is even greater. And I pray, oh God, that whatever I fail to ask for, grant them unto us, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen.